I often talk about the need to reinforce our values, the values which define us as a society. It's okay if you've got a different set of values, but there are a lot of things that we all have in common. And right now, we have to find those things in common to determine our approach to what is clearly expansion plans of the Chinese Communist Party here in Australia. Look, we are under attack. You can't look at it in any other way, what they've done to our trade situation with their country, the fact that you've got people in the bureaucracy who are running around saying, oh, it's easy, let's just trade with China. Lots of money comes really quick and fast. A few captains of industry doing the sorts of things as well. But to my mind, there's a void of the values and the vision that this country needs. If you look at some of the decisions that have been made by various governments, all of which seems to be, in my mind, robbing us of the future our nation deserves and which so many of our forebears actually shed blood for. I am actually very angry. I'm getting angry almost by the day. I mean, today it met again, National Cabinet, this thing that a year ago we thought, well, isn't this exciting? We'll have the COAG meeting, the meeting of Australian heads of governments, almost on a weekly, monthly basis, the coronavirus. But National Cabinet is a joke. Australia is not actually being governed as a nation. In fact, we're being oppressed and our freedoms are regressing into state-based totalitarian regimes. You know, these people, particularly on the Labor left side, they say they're progressive and apparently that's a virtue, but really they're oppressive. They are regressive. You've got some states, Queensland, Western Australia, bitching about paying their way as a result of this coronavirus economic catastrophe. You've got state failures here in Queensland where the Australian Constitution has, for 120 years, said that states remain responsible for land management issues. That's why no dams get built. But you've got Keswick Island off the Mackay coast in North Queensland is now essentially a Chinese government base and they decide who comes on there and who doesn't. You know, the terms on which people go to that island, Keswick Island, is up to Chinese authorities. The Queensland government doesn't see any problem with that. You've got the West Australian government, about to become their own country, wanting to keep a hard border, making it impossible for other Australians to get there easily. I don't know, what happened to the Constitution? I thought it was free and unfettered trade. That is, the way people can move between states. And then in Victoria, you've got Daniel Andrews targeting free speech to silence debate, and it's straight out of the Chinese Communist Party playbook. You see, what the Victorian government are currently doing is legislating to ensure that no one in Victoria will ever be able to actually have a conversation about certain issues without the fear of some sort of criminal or maybe civil legal action. They want to lower what they call the civil incitement test to allow people who basically want to be offended on behalf of others to prevail. I'm not exaggerating any of this. It's the way of the left. They believe, of course, that most people do the wrong thing, so every one of us must be controlled by rules. The left just doesn't trust people. And they don't want people, you and me, to be victims. They want us to feel vulnerable. We're easier to control that way. In Victoria, and I won't call them a state government anymore, they are the CCP affiliate government of Australia. They want to lower the threshold for criminal vilification offences so that bureaucrats essentially be able to silence others based on their own personal values. It's just like Hong Kong. And, of course, this is an attack on media freedom, which will force media organisations to think twice about publishing any news or opinion which might happen to upset anyone on the left. The political class of the left in this country now want to stifle debate and they want to use taxpayers' money to do it because you can bet they'll fund legal aid to mount a case on behalf of some apparently deserving cause and they'll target somebody somewhere. And you can bet discussion on this station, on Sky, will be targeted. I think Australia deserves much better. Could you imagine a circumstance where at this time on a Friday night in Victoria, the screen just goes blank? Because we dare to talk about a variety of things that someone in the Victorian bureaucracy might find offensive. We as a nation need a big, bold vision. We as a nation need something that brings us together. We don't need this provincial posturing that's tearing us apart. So this National Cabinet fails simply because of the people that are currently involved. Our federal government, of course, in the last few weeks has remained completely betrayed by the actions of some in the ranks. and distracted by the holy writ of too many in the media and political class. And this is simply not the Australian way.